It's Aries Spears. What up, man?
Hey, what's happening? Tom Joyner, a.k.a. Bruce Wayne, a.k.a. the Black Batman.
What's going on, Aries? It's Kim Whitley.
Hey, Sherry, Kim, beautiful what's black women. On? And I knew when I was waiting in the waiting area, I said, that's Kim, because I know that raspy Kathleen Turner voice.
Kathleen Turner voice. Oh, my God. Hey, did you see the wedding? Did you watch the wedding? Did you go to the wedding? The royal wedding.
I am 100% Negro. Of course not.
What? We loved it.
I ain't participating in that.
Oh, wow. You know.
But if Paul Mooney was at the wedding, what would he have said?
That you know black people. That wedding is a farce. Black people are black wedding. The only wedding I care about is the one between Eddie Murphy and Sherry Headley and Coming to America. I don't want to wait. Let me tell you something. That everybody knows that Meghan Markle, whatever her name is, she's not black. She's kind of sort of black. If that white boy was real, he would have got T'Challa's bodyguard from Black Panther. Can you imagine those white folks in England would have been up in arms with that black woman coming in, and they would have gone, who's this Negro woman with these big Negro lips? This big Negro nose? She should be serving us lemonade. That was a farce. If he really wanted a black woman, go get Lupita, what's her name?
Lupita.
Oh my God.
From 12 Years a Slave. That woman is a black woman. That is a black witch there. Be real. I'm just saying, be real. You're going to be real. Be real, homie. Be real.
Oh, my God.
Them white folks ain't ready for real Negroes. They're not ready.
That's not just like them.
I want him to marry a black woman that when that white boy wakes up in bed, he smells cocoa butter and pink oil moisturizer.
What is wrong with
Oh, I wish I could give y'all the X-rated version
of
this.
Thank you, Paul.
But you can.
I know you will.
I'm going to send it because white folks are scared. They're like bunny rabbits. They're scared. They know that their race is coming to an end. When Betty White goes, they're all gone. That woman is the last white woman left. She's 187 years old. Oh. Morgan Freeman and Betty White are in a race to death.
Wait. Aries, how long have you been doing Paul Mooney?
You know, a little bit, but I don't really do it too much because a lot of times when I perform, my audience is so mixed. And
black people
know Paul. And unless you're a diehard comedy fan, you don't really know Paul. So it's wasted effort.
Oh, but it's so funny.
You do Kanye, right?
No, I've never done Kanye.
You've never done Kanye?
No.
We need you to work on that one.
Yeah, I might have to put that one in the lab. And the crazy thing is, with Paul, it's not just the voice. I wish y'all could see the mannerisms.
Yeah.
Because it's the head tilt.
You got your legs crossed.
It's the legs crossed. It's the eye rolls. It all goes together.
Yeah.
You know what, Aries? Did you see the Billboard Awards? Did you see Janet and Salt and Pepper and J-Lo at the Billboard Awards?
No, I didn't catch it.
I didn't
catch it, baby. I'm like James Brown on this Comedy Road thing. I'm the hardest working man on the road.
I
hardly ever got time for TV.
Are you still on the divorce tour?
It's coming to a close.
Okay.
It's coming. That's hilarious.
Let me tell you something. No, it don't. It don't ever come to a close.
Well, you're right. But it is the horror movie that's going to end, and there won't be another sequel for a long time.
Yeah.
You know what?
Sherry, you and Aries Spears could go out together.
You know, and let me tell you something. I know a little bit of Sherry's story with the divorce thing. We need each other because we like Jay-Z and Beyonce. We both bring something to the table. And when we part ways, if we part ways, we only got to take what we brought.
I got a prenup right now, Aries.
Do you really?
I have a prenup right and a confidentiality agreement. I'm a notary.
All you got to do is just fill in the blanks, huh? You're
trying to flirt with me, all right.
And sign an initial.
But you know what, Aries, the NFL just put that ban on players. They cannot kneel. Any thoughts on that?
You know, somebody had wrote on Twitter, you know, the NFL is 80% black, so imagine how powerful of a statement it would be if for a couple of Sundays, all these black players just said, man, we all sitting out. And then I tweeted back, yeah, imagine, because that's all we going to do. Black people ain't been that united since the 60s. Mm. You know, and that money is a more powerful drug and narcotic than any real drug that ever exists. The ability to buy mansions and Maybachs and have women fall all over you. And for some of them brothers, you know, white women like uncut cocaine to them. You know, it's the purest blue magic. They not trading all that in for a cause where it ain't their own kin. You know what I mean? If it ain't your own people, even though it's your people, you know, we not doing that.
It's amazing how the NFL has spun the whole thing, because Cap and the rest of them were protesting the way black people are treated and police brutality. And they turned it into patriotism, which is not what the whole thing is about anyway.
Well, you know, listen, let's put it in perspective. You know, neo-Nazis have the ability to march down the street based on those rights, but yet black players are being punished for exercising those same rights. So, you know, if the neo-Nazis can do it, but we can't, what does that say?
Absolutely. Now, you know, Aries, this is a question we always talk about comics. If you couldn't do comedy anymore, mm-hmm. is there something, because you're so amazing at it.
Thank you.
Impersonations and characters. Right. And as an actor, what would you do?
I would be a professional woman lovemaker.
And they do have those. I'm a higher one tonight.
I'm very good.
Whoa. Who told you that?
Listen, between what
like you got a resume?
How do you know?
Because then why are you on the divorce tour?
I'm telling you.
Something's not right here.
Like the song by Drake. I shouldn't have to do this for free.
Exactly. But you know, some women just don't get it. There's always a bad apple in a bunch, but there are certain things that you can do to women, like the back of the kneecaps, the Achilles heel, you know, in between the toes, that make them pay your rent.
Wait a minute. But you Sherry, sound like my ex-husband.
I was going to say, Sherry broke out in a cold sweat.
Until I heard that one. Right. I said, we going down memory lane. Yeah. Make me pay your rent.
Yeah.
It was like back of the knees. And the
back of the knees. Yeah. I never
the middle of the toes. This is what right I'm between to the tell toes. You.
Listen, we all
know. Are those erogenous
zones?
Absolutely they are. But the problem is most men go for what's obvious. Right. Go for what's not obvious. Of course we know about the erogenous zones.
That means I got to wash more spots.
Oh, my God.
Stop it. No, you don't. No, you do not. Oh, that's called foreplay. I don't like my chitlins cleaned.
I'm done.
You're gonna be at the Addison Improv with your
yes. Tonight one show, Friday two shows, Saturday three shows, one on
ladies.
Sunday. Of course, go to the website improv.com. Type in Addison. And come
with
my,
the back of your knees,
come, not washed.
Come see my clinical sex show.
When you laugh, just throw your legs in the air.
Yes.
Professional woman love maker.
I want to see Aries perform now.
But, hey, I want to see what Aries can do.
Are you talking about on stage?
Both.
Hey, listen, Kim, let me say for the record again, and I know we've touched on it. You know, I've always had the largest crush on Kim for so long. The voice, the lips, and other things.
Well, your crush is going to match my size now, so
girl,
come on.
Kim, I want to say for the record, so there's no confusion, I will drink your diarrhea water.
You're nasty. Go see him at the end of the day. He was great until you got there. Oh, my God.